with a lot of a lot of productions like this, they tend to go towards the shade. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So can I be honest?
Yes, please.
When I first heard them promoting about WAX, I thought it was a for a dog show. And let me tell you why. Nothing, like nothing you, disrespectful.
You know when you Google WAX, the little
I was trying to secure a bag for me and my fur baby. I'm like, yo, if this is a show for like dogs, like I'm me and my baby finna get a check. And then I was like, wives and girlfriends are sports. And I'm like,
so before we, so for those listeners and for the viewers who do not know who Nishay is, let's start from the beginning and then we'll work our way up to the show. Okay.
Sure,
so who is Nishay? Where does she come from? All that good stuff.
Oh, wow. Who is Nishay? Well, first of all, I'm Nishay Caldwell from WAX Atlanta, which was a show on E! That just closed in, I think, Mexico. It was in 189 countries or 150-something. I don't know. I don't know how many countries. But I'm originally from Jacksonville, Florida, Duval County, in the building.
Okay.
And
I'm from UF?
Yes, I'm a graduate. You know I was coming. Coming
around, graduated from UF.
Yes, from the one and only University of Florida, Go Gators. And I have been here in Atlanta for the last 5 or 6 years now. It's been a while. And that's it. I'm a business owner. I'm a wife, a mom of two.
You're married to?
The
former NFL wide receiver Super Bowl champion Andre Caldwell.
Okay, she was gonna try to leave that out.
No.
I said I was married.
But you gotta say the whole.
Right, we need to know the tea. We need to know all the juicy details.
So, being an interior designer,
yeah,
and all those great things, where if somebody wanted to come to you, where could they find it? Let's go and put that plug in.
I'm located in Roswell, Georgia, but you can find us on Instagram, CHA Interiors, on Instagram, on Facebook, and on Twitter. But our website is chainteriors.com.
So, okay, I'm going to just go ahead and jump into the show.
Go ahead.
So, me knowing that you were an interior designer, mm-hmm, and when you were house hunting, when you and Andre were house hunting, mm-hmm, I was just like, okay, I just knew you were going to come out and like be decorating the house. You were like, okay, I'm going to change these cabinets to this and these cabinets to this. But you kept declining each house. I was just like,
Every room was a nightmare. It would almost have been a waste of time to kind of redecorate and renovate rooms that just, the house wasn't right for us,
right.
So it would have been almost a waste of time. Now, when it's right, then I go in and nitpick every single portion so that it's right for me. But for the most part, that house, it had a moat. It didn't have a backyard. It was right up to some water.
I mean,
my children weren't going to be in there. It was no point. Mm-hmm.
I was like for the everyday person, I was like,
Not enough, though.
Beautiful.
It might be beautiful on camera, but in person with the cobwebs and like the missing vents and
I live for her. Let me say this. When the show came on, I was watching the reviews and everybody was just like, okay, so a lot of like, okay, on camera, you would think like she come off like itchy, you would think like, gosh, like, oh, she gonna be that one, like the snuck up snooty one.
And I wasn't. Now, if you watched the whole season, you could tell that I wasn't.
But she did give her moments where she was very down to earth. You know, I like a little bourgeois snoot
snoot. I tell the truth. That's all.
And you really do.
It's just because you was light-skinned, girl. You know how they like to act. It's because you was light-skinned.
And you know what? I'm going to go ahead and admit that I'm light-skinned because it's been a hard journey for me to come to terms with the fact that I'm light.
I know you ain't been in these streets telling people you brown.
I didn't say I was brown. I just don't say I'm light-skinned. I'm a black woman.
Because I say I'm cocoa number 5.
You what?
Fight me.
Coco what?
Number 5.
Did you have that Aaliyah on your face?
Maybe.
Am
you know
I the same color as Aaliyah?
You got my resemblance.
Do? She do?
Yes, come on down. Come on down.
Okay, well, so earlier in our Hot Topics, we were talking about Aaliyah has a new makeup line coming out. How do you feel about that?
Mac is actually
The Aaliyah that's dead.
Yeah.
The dead.
Well, you know,
thank you.
Pause, because no one said anything. Selena had a makeup line to come out with Mac. And no one addressed that. But Selena, who's been gone before.
Did you say it was creepy?
That was a little creepy.
Thank you. Oh, my God.
Maybe not creepy, but cryptic.
It's weird. I don't want a dead person on my face.
You keep saying
it's not. She's old.
But even,
maybe it's her family's way.
No. Can we do something else?
You might get the 1 in a million lipstick, the 4-page letter eyeliner.
I don't want that, baby. No, I don't want that.
It's waterproof. That's the 4-page letter wash.
Get the one.
Rock the boat blush, for real.
Like. No,
I love Aaliyah. I love all her music. I don't want that.
Speaking of businesses,
sorry,
I love the dynamic between you and your husband. You can tell it's real, genuine.
Ooh, thank you. Love. It is. Yeah,
like her and her husband on camera is just like. See, I was seeing, like, my friends was fighting me. Like, let me. We used to like.
Really? You know what? Either you love me or you don't.
You that's and just, that and it really is.
And I'm fine with that. That's
and I
fine.
Was like, no, I got her back. I'm like, I'm with
thank
her.
Thank you.
I had your thank back. You. I, and I'm not saying this because you in because you in the studio. I ain't gonna blow no smoke. I really was rocking with you the whole season.
Thank
but
you.
I definitely love. Because I'm from the South,
yeah.
And I'm from deep South. So yeah. When your mom was just, you know, when she was getting in you, like,
yeah.
Why you need all that help with all them nannies and all that?
Yeah.
I was just like, yes, Mama Nushay, get her together. You know, I was just like, you know, I just love the
yeah.
Dynamic you have with your
well,
husband. It's
you.
Real genuine love. You know, like, they were, like, working out together.
Yeah.
And, you know, y'all
we do a lot. People ask me all the time, how in the world do you work with him? Do you live with him? Do you have sex with him at night? You have children with him? You feed him? You, like, 24 hours, and I'm just, we really have been best friends since
yeah,
I was
yeah.
21 years old. That was a long time
ago. How did you guys
ago.
Meet?
At the University of Florida on
oh.
Set. He played football for UF. They won a championship. They won a national championship, and they came home from winning the game, and we had a celebration at the club at night. And I had a ride from somebody else. Leaving home because we had to get home safely. Me and my girlfriend Shamika, who is now almost a pastor,
yeah,
and a wife of four.
What are you doing? That turned all
yes.
Y'all lives around.
Yeah, all of them. Y'all, nothing but the blood. Anyway, she and I were in the back of a car, and Dre runs up and he asked for my phone number. But I had known him since I was a freshman working at the dean of students office. So we interacted with each other several years before we actually started dating. But I've known him since I was 19. We've been together since I was 21.
They better have this love and football relationship.
I know, it's just like, love, like way back when.
Yeah,
speaking of other sides of you.
It's hard to think that.
Speaking of other sides of you, I love when you got Caitlin that hosting job. Because it just showed, like, okay, I can be, you know, this nice
girl. You
know
what? Caitlin is an amazing girl, and I love her so much, and I believe in her. The first time I met her, I'm like, what is holding you back? What's stopping you? And she didn't have an answer for me. She had all so much stuff going on.
She's a beautiful girl.
You wouldn't even imagine. She is amazing. That's why she won Miss Georgia. You can just feel her pageant, like, presence when you meet her. And I wasn't surprised that she won Miss Georgia, but I was surprised that she was, like, almost afraid to kind of handle two things at once. Like, you can't be a wife and you can't be a career woman at the same time. It's almost intimidating because it's a lot of work. It's hard. But I hopefully imparted a little bit of knowledge on her and helped her. And yeah, she went to New York Fashion Week and she killed it.
Speaking of New York Fashion Week, when your manager was Jamie.
When
Jamie called you, baby, I was in tears with you. I was like, and when you get down there, you better mess that runway the hell up. Yes.
She's amazing. I was not auditioning. I was not trying. I wasn't like believing myself to be a New York Fashion Week model anymore. I wasn't trying to model at all. And she was sending my pictures off almost behind my back. I knew she was taking pictures to go to the distributors and the companies we were working with. But I didn't know she was going to send it off for me to be casted in anything. And when I got picked up from McDougal, I just was like, I can't believe you did this. But I'm so grateful that somebody else believes in me even mm-hmm. when you don't believe in yourself.
Right.
So
that's
she's amazing. Hey, Jamie.
Speaking of what is McDougal?
McDougal,
the
yeah.
designer. What's the girl, not Keisha, Kiara?
Mm-hmm.
When she made that comment on the show, I was like, your homeboy who had your back, I was like, she could have kept all of that. How did that make you feel? Because in that moment, like, you got so livid.
I knew that it was going to come to a head at some point. Kiara and I are very similar in our lives, but we differ on a more... I don't know what it is that makes us so different, but our concepts and the way we live our life, I'm more free-spirited and I'm just out there and I'm bold, and she's very Southern Belle and very charming and sweethearted, and I'm not. So I think even though we have a lot of similarities, we butt heads on a lot of things as well, and something as small as me getting us. In her mind, I guess, a step above something that she may have wanted to do at one point in her life, I almost think she felt attacked. And for me, I'm just all about women's empowerment, and that hurt my feelings. That somebody would say, you know what, well, you got to Fashion Week, I could have done that too. Like, at
yeah.
the same time, well, why didn't you? Well, why
right.
wouldn't you? Well, I wasn't, you ain't going to YSL. Well, so what? I could have had a skateboard in my hand, I would have walked in Fashion Week.
Do
I
you
feel
had like...
sunglasses on, I would have walked in Fashion
right.
Week. I didn't care. It was like a pinnacle in my career that I've been modeling since I was 14 years old, and it was something that I've been passionate about for a long time, because black women don't model is the,
yeah.
the huge stereotype, and I wanted to be a part of a reason we do, you know. And so when she came at me through somebody else with that, I just was like, girl. Yeah. So like, you saw, girl, bye.
When you said she, you felt like you had one up than her, do you feel like she treats her sister that way? I feel like she plays the big sister role of I have more, and... You know,
I think all of our real characteristics about ourselves really came out in the show. So if that's what you perceive, then yes, that is the truth.
Ooh. So we're going to put a push pin right there. You guys stay tuned in. Do not go nowhere. That was so country. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. We got Nashay from Wags Atlanta. God damn. Let me remix that back. We got Nashay from Wags. It's done. It's out of here. Nashay from Wags Atlanta. Your DJ Papa Smurf on the ones and twos about to spin. Y'all stay tuned in. It's WTNT's Q in the Streets. Woo.
Jeez. Don't you take another sip.
I'm not. I'm done.
Take another sip.